Oh my gosh, look at all of our wonderful furry and feathered friends. Oh my gosh, and they're like the perfect audience. This is the first time I've heard laughter in 5 months.
Be used to it. I laugh a lot.
Okay. Please keep going. Keep going. Thank you so much for joining, Shannon and Chanatsu. This is so wonderful. Shannon, you're at the Mountain Peaks Therapy.
With Llamas and Alpacas.
It's a mouthful. And yes. Down here below, we've got Chinetsu with Kiki and May.
Yes.
And we have over here Kanye Westy.
Yes, Kanye. Hi.
Kanye, say hi. Hold on a second. I've got this.
Hi, friends.
And this is Chewy over here.
Aww.
Thank you both so much for joining. This is really exciting for our pet special. And thank you for allowing us the tour of your farm and to hang out with the geese nursery. This is so wonderful. Now, you two know each other, right? Shannon, you had told us, hey, get in touch with Chinatsu. The geese are great. You know, let's have a – this is our animal happy hour. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Shannon.
Oh, of course, it's so good to see you, even if it's just virtually.
Let's talk about that right away. Both your animals bring therapy. What is the therapy been like during the pandemic? I mean, have you sort of been hoarding the therapy, or has there been digital ways to engage people with your animals?
Yeah, I was really, really thankful that there was an animal sanctuary in California that went viral for doing Zoom calls with llamas. And so we jumped right on that. And so now we do a lot of classroom field trips and we'll interrupt people's business phone calls and do virtual Zooms just like this, where you get to meet all of them face to face.
Well, let's meet. We've also. Who's right there? Who's the fellow with the auburn, you know, sort of brown colored hair?
This is Andre.
Andre.
And this is Captain Jack.
And Captain Jack.
And this is Diego. He's our naughty, spicy alpaca.
What makes him naughty and spicy?
He hasn't quite learned his manners yet. So we got him when he was a year and a half old, and he was very sweet and affectionate. But then once he hit puberty, he kind of doesn't understand personal boundaries very well. And so that's why I usually advise, and why we typically get animals that are between 3 and 5 years old, because then they've come out of puberty and they've kind of leveled out. So we're still working on bonding, even though he's 5. I learned boundary issues.
Chinatsu, how long have you been friends with Kiki and May?
Kiki and May were born on April 15th last year. So they are 1 year old.
Oh, how cool. What? So they had a quarantine birthday. My birthday is April 9th. So the geese and I we're all Aries.
Yes.
That's so cool. Now I see you're feeding that youngster something there. What were you feeding them there, Shannon?
They love to eat carrots. So, we find it very therapeutic to feed them carrots. So we always encourage folks to feed them. But there's something very unspoken about bonding with an animal when you give them a treat.
Sure.
You know, everyone wants to give a dog a treat or you know, for us, it's the llamas. And we find that carrots tend to be the most universal way that people can hold them. Grain, you almost always have to have a flat hand, but not everyone we visit can open a hand or even have hands to feed them with. So we find that having carrot slices, you can even put it in your lips and get a carrot kiss. And so that's one of our favorite activities when we're not in a pandemic, to encourage everyone to come out and kiss all of the llamas.
I think you very just gentle. Found yourself with a little quarantine there.
Awesome.
Now, now let me ask you, Chinatsu, what are geese treats? What do geese like to gobble up?
So they love romaine lettuce.
Yes.
Or the Trader Joe's old Cheerios.
Oh.
This is their favorite.
Oh, I'll tell you. We'll all enjoy a little snack time. Kanye West's favorite is apples. One of his nicknames is Horse Pup. Yay! Yeah, yeah. Horse Pup. Do do do. I can't get enough of feeding that little dude apples. It cracks me up every time. Chewy, do you want to let Chewy's being a little grouchy. He's 13 after all, so he's. It's nap time for him. Choo choo. Good boy. Now, let's talk, Shannon. You had a legend that was at your farm. Rojo,
yeah.
The llama, was a service llama for 17 years?
He was 17 when he passed away.
17
years. And he was a therapy llama for 12 years. So my mom and I, here's my mom, by the way, I'll introduce her. She's the OG llama mama.
Oh, OG mama
that's
llama.
Lori.
That's a great rapper name.
I'm llama mama 2.0. But, we started sharing our animals 13 years ago, starting with Rojo. He was our very first llama we bought when he was, we found him at 3 months old on his farm when we went llama shopping. And then he was my 4-H animal for 5 years. And then after showing him at our county fair and walking him in parades and just treating him like my dog, and he just loved human interaction and attention, that we got him certified through Dev Lewis Animal Hospital right in downtown Portland to share for therapy. And so then we went to nursing homes and special needs schools and hospitals all throughout the area. And that kind of gave us our whole ministry. So we became Mountain Peaks Therapy Llamas and Alpacas in 2013. And then we just started growing our herd with the special thought process of finding very sweet and social animals to share with the public. So now we have 13.
Wow. And now you said hospitals. Now, Chinatsu, what sort of places have your geese are essentially therapy geese too. You ask people, you say, hey, please pet them. They're very friendly, right?
Yes. Because my geese attract a great deal of attention when we are in public. I have been asked to bring them to the local events. And when I had Lulu, who is the legend,
Lulu the legend, that was your last goose.
We were invited to local schools and introduce her to children and teachers in order to educate them about her breed and waterfowl general. Also, we have participated local charity events as well. Now, I pay very close attention.
Bless you. Did you see that?
Yeah, that was a sneeze.
Extra close attention to my geese and people, especially to the children at the same time. All the time I'm teaching children how to treat waterfowl. It makes a good sense to teach children early and to, infuse their education with kindness and compassion. So their reaction and decisions are based on an automatic reflex of caring and loving behavior.
Sure. Now, I know with a dog, it's always good to ask the owner first. You come with, the backside of the hand, let them sniff it first. For a goose, what's a good way to approach a goose that is a, like Kiki and May?
Kiki is very affectionate, as Shannon knows, and everyone.
Now, which one? Kiki has to be in your lap when you're speaking of affection.
This is
yes.
Kiki.
Clearly, I can see, as we have literally like a picture frame of May on the side, just sort of making sure everything's all right. Oh my gosh, hold on a second. I have to show this to you. Wow. I have something that is almost the perfect frame if May stays. I'll be right back.
Okay.
This is, you get to do this kind of thing when you're doing a show at home. I could not resist. My mother has these incredible bookends, and I have a good feeling. I'm hoping this was worth it.
Oh my God.
How about that? Not too
Oh,
shabby.
I love it. That must be vintage. But she's a very quieter than Kiki.
She's very stoic. I gotta say, what an incredibly stoic goose. It's really, I'm not sure who's more stoic, May or old Brassy here. Now you recently had with your geese some pretty cool adventures. You know, while we're in this pandemic, you know, we haven't gotten to travel as much. Things are opening up. You just did a coastal tour, and were they in a wedding?
Yes, we were invited to a friend's wedding, and we just had a blast.
That's incredible. Had your friends met Kiki and May before?
No, it was a lot of, you know, public to join, and they were so fascinated.
I bet. I mean, first of all, yeah, everyone is probably just happy in general to be out of the house, but then you add geese into the mix, you know, wedding, that's my kind of wedding. I know that Kiki May, you know, had just done a wedding. Do your llamas ever do like 80s dance parties? Because I have this weird feeling that llamas invented the feathered bangs. Look at that. That mane is like perfect.
I can see it.
Sweet rock band all these guys should be in. Como se llama? Come on. It's got to happen.
I could totally say that. That'd be awesome. They almost look like they're wearing bell bottoms anyways with the way their haircuts are.
This guy over here looks like he's got a toupee on to your left, one over.
This one here.
With the ginger, yeah. Just one more over. Yeah, that looks like he probably goes up into the retirement home and, you know, guy's like, man, that's just about as good as mine does up here.
Yeah, he's a sweetheart. But that's Maximus.
That's Maximus.
The alpacas are very social. And this is Captain Jack.
Chewy, that little guy's got an underbite just like you do.
It's so cute.
Oh, this is so, you're an author. You aren't just someone that raises and breeds these animals. You're a children's book author. Tell us about that.
You know, my mom and I always thought that we would pair up with someone to do a children's book. And so when I was thinking about brainstorming what I would want in said children's book, I accidentally ended up writing the whole thing and found a local illustrator here up in Vancouver, Washington. And then I had a book, and, you know, I really wanted to make it official by having a second book and kind of start a series. And so that's where is my hair came from. So the first book is really inspired by Rojo's story, how he became a therapy llama.
As I waited to enter the show ring, an elderly man came over to wish me good luck. He had never met a llama before and was impressed with the kindness I showed him. I like to be petted and make new friends, I told him. He gave me a hug and asked if I would come to visit his retirement home when the fair was over. I promise, I yelled back as I entered the show ring.
You could hug him all you wanted to. Aww. I've had kids like crawl underneath his body, and he would just stand there. He was so safe and so responsible in crowds. And so, you know, he was just made for something that wasn't what llamas were made for.
That's so great. I feel like all of our animals sort of have a certain vanity in common, but also a certain compassion, which is really, really awesome. Now with Kiki and May, you said that they obviously are very photogenic. What kind of modeling have they done?
They have.
I had this feeling that like that Kiki's just waiting to get in her modeling session and put on her ballerina, you know, outfit and get to it and get the sweet shots in Vogue or, you know, or Geese.
She definitely likes to be paid attention. All of attention's on her. She just sits in a stroller quietly.
Oh, May just sits in a stroller? That would God, I need to go to more parks where there are geese in strollers.
Yeah, China Sue is always fabulous. And you know, she didn't even cover the fact of how she walks her geese.
Please
will you
tell us
will
about...
you explain your leash?
Wait, you have a geese leash?
It's on a string of pearls.
This is living a real good life.
That's how I had to meet her. I heard that there was a goose that walks around in a string of pearls, and I went, I have to meet this goose.
And Kiki is wearing a big pearl necklace today. Kiki is wearing a big pearl necklace today.
Oh my gosh, I noticed. Now, did Kiki have a dress on? I know that Lulu wore tutus. Lulu wore tutus. There's your children.
She has a bow. She has a bow.
She's a big and bow they, and... Kanye, we got to step up your game.
The fun thing about these animals, the llamas and alpacas, they don't bite because they don't have enough teeth. So in llamas and alpacas and animals that chew their cud, so goats and cows and sheep and deer are the same way. They only have bottom front teeth in their mouth. They're like this. So they can't bite you. They have a hard palate on the top. You can see in Smokey's mouth. He's our smiling llama. You can see him.
That's amazing.
And then they have two top lips and one bottom lip that they move all independently like fingers. That's why they're such good gentle kissers, because they just use their lips to pick up the food. And so you don't have to worry about them ever biting you.
Holy sweet moly, look at that underbite.
Yeah, they're related to camels. So they have, oh my gosh, Andre, he's such a carrot thief. So they have three lips in total that they use like fingers to grab their food.
Wait, yeah. You said, oh my gosh, I just saw it.
Yeah, do you see? I need to get these little alpacas. They're so annoying. Oh, okay.
That's what happens when you're at, you know, animal happy hour. Stuff starts getting
ready. There we go. See how he takes up his lips? And they have back top and bottom molars. So that's why they chew all the way back here. That's why their mouths are so funny, because they're chewing all the way back here. Then that's they look great. Like the Carlton dance.
That's so cool. Well, kisses to all of you. Kisses to the llamas and the geese and the pups. Hey, you say hi? Okay. Good outro, Kanye. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, llamas. Thank you, geese.
Thank you.
Good night, cow. Good night, moon.